Okay, so in today's video, what we're going to be really talking about is advanced plyometric exercises. And what we're going to be needing in today's video is, of course, we're going to need some hurdles that I have set up roughly in that formation. And you don't need to have hurdles. You can literally tape lines down on the ground. However, hurdles will give you that extra height. And we're going to need one hurdle in front, one on each side right there. And then we're going to have two more set up exactly vertically to the first one that we set up. We are also going to need a medicine ball with a step. Now you can use a ledge like this one, or you can use a step like this one, and of course all of the links are down in the description below. So again, we don't need anything special. You don't need to go out and buy any of this equipment, but if you do, the links are down below, and of course those are not sponsored links, but I do make a commission off of that. So really quickly, in this first workout or this first exercise, what we're going to do is to be up on our toes. You generally want to be up on your toes the whole time throughout all of these exercises that I'm about to show you. From there, we're gonna start by taking a quick hop over top of this first hurdle, and then we're going to then hop sideways. Now, from there, it basically comes down to how I like to run this is to do 10 on the same side, and then switch sides and do 10 on the other side. So we would do 10 going sideways and then forwards, and then we would go 10 this way, sideways and then forwards. Now, I actually prefer doing this on grass, and there's a good reason for that. Either grass or sand are my favorites versus something like a cement tile or concrete or whatever. I prefer to have grass or cement or grass or sand, mainly because it's a lot easier on your knees. Meanwhile, if your grass is wet, don't do it. And also, with the sand, it's a little bit better of a workout. You can actually stack this drill by doing a drop-off squat and then sideways front. And then, of course, whatever you do on one side, you also want to do on the other as well. And now we're going to be moving over to my other step. Of course, you can purchase that down in the description below. However, the reason is because now we're going to use the pavement for something. Okay, so the first part of this workout or this exercise, we don't need a medicine ball just yet, because we want to do more on the basic side first. So what we're going to do is have our foot back on top of this step. Now, preferably, if it starts sliding, if you don't have rubber feet on yours, you can put this back against a wall or a garage door in this case. You can have your foot back, and then you're going to go down for a lunge and then back up. Down for a lunge and then back up. Now, this may seem super simple. That's why we're going to add a ball in. So with a ball, what we're going to do is go down into our lunge. We're going to try and be up on our toe, and we're going to pound down, dribble. And you're going to do that for 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 20 seconds, or longer. Then you're going to step back with your left foot. Again, be on your toe here. Down, dribble with your left hand. And then you can hold that for 15, 20 seconds. You can go longer if you want. Now this one, we're gonna go back to the ledge here. We're gonna again take a step away, have our foot back. We're gonna go down into our lunge, explode up into a squat, and then jump up. And then remember, whatever we do to one leg, we wanna do the exact same to the other. So squat down, jump up, squat, just like that. You're gonna go for either a time limit, so you can go for 45 seconds, 30 seconds, or you can do reps. So you can do, let's say, 3 sets of 15 or 3 sets of 20. Now for this next one, we can use hurdles, we can use an agility ladder that I have right here, or if you can see really closely, I've taped a agility ladder of my own on the driveway of my driveway. Wow, I'm out of breath. I can't even think straight, can I? But anyways, so it's a really hot day today. But anyways, what we're going to do here is I like this with younger players with the hurdles, mainly because it makes them jump higher. But what we're going to do here is we're going to, when we go this way, we're going to go 1 foot and then 2 feet. See how I jumped ahead one square when I jumped ahead? We're going to go back this way on our right foot, jumped ahead, left going right, right going left, landing on both feet on each side. So to go a little bit quicker, it would look like this. And then of course, if we had hurdles here, it would just be the same thing, except you'd be jumping higher. This is going to work on not just your speed, but also your coordination and your vertical jump too. Now in this next drill, what we're going to be doing is having just one hurdle. If you don't have a hurdle, that's totally okay. You can use literally anything you want. You can use bricks, you could even use a pylon. And from here, what we're gonna be doing is trying to only jump with our calves. You can use a little bit of your knees, and depending on how new you are to this drill, you would wanna use a little bit more of your thighs and your calves, and maybe a little bit more of your arms. But if you're new, you should be still be able to do that. This is only a 6-inch hurdle, so it's not that high. However, if you're younger, you might wanna get down a little bit lower, but you really wanna be on your toes. And you generally wanna go back and forth over top of this hurdle. So there's some advanced plyometrics for you to be able to jump higher. Now, in future videos, we're going to be using something what's called a BOSU ball, which is what I'm standing on right now. So definitely hit that like button, subscribe, and check out further videos.